Assalamualaikum. I am Shafi from Sumikan Asia Pacific Japan, and today I will be speaking regarding the rise of China's economy. First, I will be speaking about the history. Prior to the initiation of economic reforms and the free market, nearly 40 years ago, China maintained policies that kept the economy very poor, stagnant, centrally controlled, vastly inefficient, and relatively isolated from the global economy. Curious about why China has done so well? Based on IMF research team recently examined the source of that nation's growth and arrived at a surprising conclusion. Although capital accumulation, the growth in the country's stock of capital assets such as new factories, manufacturing machinery, and communication system was important, as were the number of Chinese workers, a sharp sustained increase in productivity was the driving force behind the economy boom. During 1979 and 1994, productivity gains accounted for more than 42% of China's growth, and by the early of 1990s, it had overtaken capital as the most significant source of growth. This marks a departure from the traditional view of development in which capital investment takes the lead. This jump in productivity originated in economic reforms begun in 1978. Since opening up the foreign trade and investment and implementing free market reforms in 1979, China has been among the world's fastest growth economy, with real annual gross domestic product, or known as GDP, growth averaging 9.5% through 2018, a pace described by the World Bank as fastest sustained expansion by a major economy in history. Such growth has enabled China on average to double its GDP every 8 years and help raise an estimated 800 million people out of poverty. China has become the world's largest economy for manufacturer, merchandise trader, and holder of foreign exchange reserves. This in turn has made China a major commercial partner of the United States of America. China is the largest US merchandise trading partner, biggest source of imports, and the third largest US export market. China is also the largest foreign holder of US Treasury securities, which help fund the federal debt and cap US interest rates low. That's it from me, and thank you. Assalamualaikum.